बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलामुअलैकुम एंड हाय एवरीवन, वेलकम टू कुक विद हसीबा। इन टुडेज वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू शो यू हाउ टू मेक ए सिंपल चिकन अखनी विद द इंग्रेडिएंट्स अवेलेबल एट होम इन अ बैंगलोर स्टाइल। द इंग्रेडिएंट्स आई हैव टेकन आर हाफ अ केजी चिकन विथ बोन, वन ऑनियन पेस्ट, वन टमेटो फाइनली चॉप्ड, वन टमेटो प्यूरीड, few mint leaves, 2 teaspoon ginger and garlic paste, a pinch of turmeric powder which is optional, 1 tablespoon curd, half lemon juice, 1 teaspoon chili powder, 2 teaspoon coriander powder, 1/4 teaspoon garam masala powder and some salt to taste. You can always adjust the spices as per your taste. Now in a pan or a kadai, take some oil. Now I am not going to heat the oil too much here as we are adding the onion paste directly. It will splutter very badly if you heat the oil too much. Just wait until the oil is bit warm and then add the onion paste. Now again, don't fry the onion paste too much here. Just wait until the color changes and then add the ginger garlic paste. Now we are going to saute the ginger garlic paste until the color changes or until the raw smell of the ginger garlic paste is faded away. We have to fry them well, mostly for akhni. The ginger garlic should be turned brown in color. Once the ginger garlic is sauteed well, add the washed chicken. Now on top of chicken, just add a bit of turmeric and some salt. Now I'm adding very little salt here as it's only for the chicken. For the masala, I will add it later. Mix the chicken well with the ginger garlic and onion paste. I'm going to mix the chicken so well or fry the chicken so well that the chicken should be cooked at least 50% here. Now the raw smell of the chicken should be completely faded away, the color should be changed and the chicken should be 50% done here. Add some mint leaves on top of the chicken for that beautiful aroma of akhni and then cover the lid and cook for at least 5 to 7 minutes so that the flavor of the mint can completely get absorbed by the chicken. Now open the lid. After 5 to 7 minutes you can see such beautifully the chicken is been cooked. Now 50% of the chicken was cooked here and the flavor of the mint was completely absorbed by the chicken. Just give a gentle mix and then add the spices. That's the chili powder and the coriander powder. Now for the akhni, we add very little turmeric powder, or if you want to skip adding turmeric you can also do that. Now saute the masala well or the spices well until the raw smell of the masala can fade away. Now it is very important process that we always have to saute the spices very well. There shouldn't be any kacha masala smell. Now once the spices are sauteed well and the raw smell is gone, I'm going to add the chopped tomato and also the tomato puree. Now I'm adding them together so that the chicken can get well cooked with the tomatoes. As we are not adding any water to this gravy, it is very much necessary that you have to cook the tomatoes at this point of time. The tomato quantity should get reduced to half and the oil should get separate. Cover the lid and let it cook for at least 7 to 10 minutes so that the chicken should be completely done here. Now after 10 minutes just open the lid. As you can see, the chicken was actually done here but still the tomato chunks were visible, so just give them a gentle mash and then add the kasturi methi. Now whenever you add kasturi methi, you always make sure to rub the kasturi methi with your palm and then add them. Just don't directly add the kasturi methi. This will give you a very good flavor and the aroma of the kasturi methi will come out when you rub them with your palm. Just give a good mix after adding the kasturi methi and then add the curd and the lemon juice. As curd and lemon juice doesn't need too much of time to cook, just add them and give a good mix. Now I'm going to add a pinch of food color to this gravy. If you want to skip it, you can surely do. As you can see, I have added just a pinch of red food color. Now whenever you add the food color to any gravy, you always make sure you have to dilute the food color with some water and then add. If you directly add the food color, The color will be visible only at one part of the gravy. It won't get eventually divided. Now the chicken yakhni was ready here. I'm adding a bit of salt. You can always adjust the spices according to your taste. As I added very little salt in the beginning, I added some more here. Now I'm adding the garam masala powder for the final touch. Cover the lid and let it cook for 2 to 3 minutes. After 2 to 3 minutes, the chicken yakhni was ready here, but I'm not immediately going to serve this. Let it rest for 10 minutes on the stove after switching off the flame. Whenever you serve any gravy, just to get that beautiful layer of oil on top of the gravy, it is always necessary that you have to switch off the flame and let the gravy rest on the stove for few minutes. If you are in a hurry, at least let it rest for 5 minutes. Only then you can get this layer of oil on top. Now the dish was ready to serve. You can eat this chicken yakhni either with roti or ghee rice or paratha or naan or any kind of bun. Now this was the final look of the chicken yakhni. You can garnish it with some spring onion and julienne ginger, or you can also garnish with some coriander leaves. Now if you like my recipes, then please do like, share, comment and subscribe to my channel, and also let me know what recipe you want me to upload next. Thank you so much for watching.